I'm Steve from Ember, and I want to show you these tags. They're used to prove the authenticity of designer goods. Inside each one is a microchip that uses near-field communication. It uses blockchain technology, similar to Bitcoin, to create an unforgeable public record of ownership. Normally, a product like this would be injection molded, but the heat from the molten plastic would damage the circuitry on the chips, and the custom logo on the front of these tags and the unique serial number on the back would require custom tooling for each part. And that's why 3D printing is a great way to make these devices. Here's Chris, the co-founder of Origin, on why they used Ember 3D printer to manufacture these tags.
When we originally tried to make these smart tags, we started with FDM technology, which is sort of the run-of-the-mill 3D printer you can buy as a desktop printer. And it makes a good prototype to give you a rough idea of what it should look like. The next thing we tried is what's regarded as the highest quality 3D printing process, which is SLA. Again, we created a nice prototype here. We also tried an industrial multi-jet printer. These can range from a few hundred thousand dollars up to $1 million. Ultimately, when we use the Ember, because it prints the entire layer at once, it produces a much better finish. And because the Ember is open source, we're able to modify primarily the software to allow us to do things like embed the NFC chip directly into the smart tag, as well as engrave it with a custom serial number and do the multi-tone color. This is a complete product that can compete with injection molding. We can do it on the Ember.
Here's how these tags are made in Origin's production lab. They are printed in three stages: the main body, the base, and the logo. They send the print file for the main body to an Ember. The build head lowers into a tray of red colored resin. The part will form on the aluminum face of the build head. Blue light from beneath the tray prints the first layer. The tray slides away and back again to print the next layer. 35 layers and 4 minutes later, the build head rises from the resin and the main body is finished. On one side, there is a rim. This is where the microchip is inserted. In production, the part is left on the build head and the chip is inserted in the upside down part. Now they send the print file for the base to the Ember. It will print directly over the chip, completely encasing it in plastic. This print file also includes the serial number. Origin software uses Ember's open source architecture to generate a unique number for each print file. After this print is finished, they remove the build head from the Ember and take it to a press, where they slide the parts off the build head. They 3D print a fixture on a build head that fits the tag bodies, which ensures alignment when printing the logo. The build head goes back onto an Ember, this time with white resin, and the logo is printed in about 2 minutes. They remove the tags from the fixture, clean them, and after a quick UV cure, they have a final product. Using this procedure, they had only one failure in a run of 600. Ember is open from the mechanics to the electronics, which enables many aspects of Origin's workflow. For example,
being able to customize Ember's print settings to a specific material allowed us to experiment with pretty much every resin on the market. We've written software to largely automate most of the printing process on Ember. And then from there, we've actually built on top of the printing process on Ember. You know, being able to print over PCBs and NFC inlays, as well as being able to do multiple colors, are things that we're able to do because Ember's open source. And going forward, there's a lot more that we can do, which, you know, really exciting.
We really love working with Origin because we've learned a lot about how 3D printers are used in a production environment. If you want to learn more about Origin, visit madebyorigin.com. They make more than just these tags. And if you want to learn more about these tags, visit chronicle.com. If you're interested in developing a 3D printing workflow for your product, send us an email, and together we'll figure out if Ember is a good fit for you. Or at the very least, we'll point you in the right direction. And if you want to see more videos about Ember and 3D printing, subscribe to the channel. We'd love for you to leave comments and tell us what you want to see. I dropped that.